Asher Underwood here on behalf of TruthAboutTexas.com and GreatHanging1862.com. I first want to say all respect due to the Most High and to the ancestors without whom I wouldn't be here. This is native land, and thank you, rest in peace, rest in power, L.D. Clark, for paving the way. If it wasn't for you, this history would still be covered up by the sons and daughters of the Confederacy and the city of Gainesville, and all you people that ain't from Gainesville, whose ancestors ain't from Gainesville, have nothing to do with the Great Hanging, who come here and want to keep this quiet, because it's clear to see for me that all the red states in the South are the same states that supported the Confederacy. Okay, as this monument clearly explains, when Abraham Lincoln became president, South Carolina seceded from the Union. It's a series of other slave states seceded from the Union, okay? Texas was the seventh state to secede, and then shortly after, the Conscription Act was issued that required all able-bodied white males 18 to 35 to go fight on behalf of the Confederacy. The problem is, Cook County, Texas was one of the few counties in Texas that voted against secession, because the majority, a large majority, 90% of the 700 poor white families that was here farming, just trying to survive, was opposed to secession of Texas to join the Confederacy, and didn't feel like it was in their benefit to leave their homes, to leave their families, to go fight a rich man's war, just like the poor continue to do to this day, go fight rich men's war and continue to vote against their own interests. So less than 10% of the 700 white families in the 1860s were slaveholding families, but yet they ran it, and they ran the kangaroo court that was set up to convict and hang over 40 white males that was accused of conspiring with a peace party to incite either a slave insurrection or to re-establish Union control of North Texas, right? So it was after William C. Young was shot, bow! John Brown had been tearing shit up in Kansas, and the slaveholders, which was a minority, were afraid, as they should have been, because it's wrong. You gotta remember that at the outset of the Civil War, hemp was the number two cash crop in the country. It was only Eli Whitney's development of the cotton gin which propelled the South and the Southern aristocratic elite to a whole nother level. And the slave economy didn't just benefit plantation owners. It didn't just benefit the slave master up on the plantation beating slaves. But these same plantation owners was tied in churches, was building the infrastructure and the economy of the South that still stands today. Not just the South, but the whole U.S. benefited from the economy of cotton, and international players was involved too. That's why I looked to John Brown's son Owen in his testimony in Cloud Splitter, where he explains that the Civil War, the so-called Civil War, to them was just another protracted battle and a war that had been fought over 300 years from the day the first enslaved African hit Virginia. Okay, from the Haiti uprising, the Nat Turner Rebellion, to the Underground Railroad in Ohio and New York, to the firing of Fort Sumner and a Shiloh of Appomattox Courthouse, and then the murder of Abraham Lincoln and the bloody days that followed, quote unquote, paraphrase Owen Brown, right? So there was fires that was being set all over North Texas, and the Union sympathizers and Peace Party members issued a petition that over 150 men signed and said they didn't want to have nothing to do with going and fighting the rich man's war, fighting for the Confederacy, right? So the Master Masons that I could go through and name to you that was the slaveholding minority and elite of Cook County, they went and rounded everybody up with a militia in October 1861. Right, in over 3 weeks, over 40 men were hanged either by court or by mob action or by subsequent violence that ensued. Right, but the court convicted on originally, it didn't even require a majority vote, and it was punishing people by death when on the books of the Confederacy, treason was only punishable by 3 to 5 years in prison. Right. But no one ever faced any charges for the actions that ensued. And of course, even still to this day, it took us 150 years, thanks to L.D. Clark and the Clark family and everyone that has kept this alive. It took over 150 years to have any true, real monument to exist. And Rich McCaslin, one of the foremost academics on the Great Hanging, you should check out Taine and Breeze, again, or check out Great Hanging 1862. He's pointed out that the point of excavating this history and understanding this history and understanding vigilante mob violence is to prevent these sort of actions from happening again in the future. It's a clear comparison for me in looking at, again, looking at the Tea Party, looking at the red states in the South, and those connections with the consciousness of slavery and the consciousness of the Confederacy. Like, we gotta really be real about what happened in the past, whether our ancestors were or were not involved, and understanding how these intersections of time and history affect not only our current era, but how and where we will go into the future. As my hat says, why be divided? No country or nation divided has ever withstood the test of time. That's why there's no nation remaining today. From Rome, Babylon, Greek, Egypt, all these slaveholding nations collapse, all right? And the wealth inequality in this country and the world is at an all-time high. Less than 2% of the world's population could feed and clothe 100 million malnourished people in the world in an instant. But they don't. Why? Political, economic reasons. Who benefits when we go to war? Weapons manufacturers, oil companies, Lockheed Martin. Don't get me started. Come on, y'all. And you know, you can go back and you can do the math on the companies here in the U.S. that supported Hitler and the Third Reich. When that was popping off, Hitler was on the radio in the United States. So you can't tell me that from the day that that first enslaved African hit the shore, to the Civil War, to Jim Crow South, and to the current era where a black man is killed by police every 24 hours in this country. And there's always been white allies in the fight for freedom, justice, and equality for all. As Martin Luther King said, injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere, right? So I ain't hearing that, oh, it's in the past, it's not relevant, because those that really know their facts and know their history know it is relevant. And I really urge you to learn this forgotten, lost piece of not only American history, Texas history, Civil War history, but possibly a part of your own history. You need to come check out the monument here in Gainesville, Texas, Great Hanging 1862, for directions and more information about the movement. Hit me up, Asher Underwood, truthabouttexas.com, legalizedtexas.com, truthmovements.com in general. We're gonna keep this real, real stuff coming to you and for your family for the new year. So I'm wishing everybody big things in 2015. Salute.
Is on fire, smell that smoke. No one's panicking, no one's getting choked. Vortex flow next till all of y'all learn. The South is on fire, wanna gonna let it burn. It's on fire, I smell smoke. No one's panicking, no one's getting choked. Vortex flow next till all of y'all learn. The South is on fire, wanna gonna let it burn. It's on fire, it's on fire, it's on fire.